Hey, it's Danny Clinch, and we are here to talk about a Clinch Crates sale that I'm going to be doing in Asbury Park. We're going to do a little something different this year that I haven't done yet, which is I went into my storage facility and I pulled out a bunch of prints that were part of gallery shows that I've had in Asbury Park and elsewhere, really. I'm going to just put those up at a discount price because I have so many of them, and I think they should be hanging in somebody's house. These are all one-offs, so there's only going to be one at that price that is framed and that had hung in one of these shows. What's really exciting is I did a gallery show in Asbury Park in 2009. It was Bruce Springsteen's 60th birthday, and my buddy Tim Donnelly had a thought. He said, hey, we could rent a little space up on the boardwalk and we could do a show of all photographs of Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band that were shot only in New Jersey. And so as you can see over here, it's not just Bruce, but it's also the E Street Band. A lot of these were shot in New Jersey. This was at the Convention Hall. I actually took this photograph on my birthday on January 24th, and it was a big birthday present for me. These are all framed. You'll be able to come and have a look at the gallery, which will be at the Asbury Hotel. It'll be around the back where we can be socially distanced. It's like an indoor-outdoor space. One of my favorites here really is this photograph of Danny Federici. And the other thing I wanted to say about this this session or this gallery show that I did in Asbury Park, which we called Be True. My dad, Max, came up to help us repaint the space that we had rented on the boardwalk. So I called Bruce and I said, hey Bruce, you know, we're about to take the show down. If you want to come by and check it out. Sure enough, a little while later, Bruce and Patty showed up. I think it was a 51 Hudson convertible with the top down. We were totally blown away by it. It was amazing. Patty offered to let my dad drive her car. And so my dad and Bruce hopped in this Hudson. Little did I know that this photograph, having been taken on 4th and Kingsley, would be a block away from where what is now the Transparent Clinch Gallery. We're gonna have a ticketing system that allows us to book a time in half hour increments so that everybody can shop safely without rushing. Of course, you'll be wearing masks and socially distancing. In the event that things don't get any better, we will do this all virtually. We look forward to seeing everybody, and it's gonna be November 27 and 28, and at the Asbury Hotel. You know, we'll give you some information on the World Wide Web, and it's gonna be fun. I'll see you there. Welcome to Transparent Gallery. I'm Danny Clinch, and we are in Asbury Park. And we've come up with an idea to do a couple of episodes that we're gonna call Locals and Icons. And so we're asking a bunch of the local musicians that we know, folks who've come here and hung out with us and played music with us on the stage here, to come in and pick out a photograph they love of an artist that they love. And we would have a discussion about it. I would talk about what the assignment was maybe and a good story behind it. And they'll talk about how that artist has inspired them and what they love about them, and then they're gonna perform a song, a cover song by that artist. So it's gonna be really exciting. We have a great bunch of people that are gonna contribute, and we appreciate you coming out. Thank you very much. Here we are again for a Locals and Icons moment here at the Transparent Gallery. And we have Rachel Ana Dobken here, who is living in Asbury Park these days, and was one of the first to come here and play at the gallery, which is exciting. We've had so much great live music here. And you know, this idea, as you know, is to have an artist come in and talk about one of my photographs and a band that they love, and be able to share stories about it. And of course, maybe play a song. I took this photograph that Rachel loves in Amsterdam in 1993 with Blind Melon. We were on tour and we were going through Amsterdam. What a drag. And, you know, Amsterdam is a bicycling city and we rented all these bicycles. And shortly into the bike ride, Shannon lost the key to the lock of his bicycle.
Naturally.
And wouldn't stop harping on the fact that he lost the key. And we just followed him all around, you know, the block several times.
Did you guys find it?
No. I'm not sure what we found in Amsterdam, but it wasn't the key. But this was, as we were cruising around, this was just such a natural moment. And we were about to cross and we saw this bus coming. So I shouted everyone to come look my way. And then I just grabbed the photo. So there we go. And I was wondering, what is your draw to Blind Melon and how you feel about the band?
Well, they've always been a band for me. So it's interesting because this photo was taken when I was 3 years old. And Shannon died when I was 5. So I didn't really get a chance to really dive into their music until I was older and in high school. And at that time, I was like really exploring more of the alt, sort of indie 90s, starting with Incubus. And then I discovered them. I feel like the first song I heard was Soup. And like, aside from No Rain, right? Because everyone's heard No Rain.
Yeah.
And we know the story behind that. But then I started listening to that whole record. And it's a record for me that remains so timeless. Like, it's one of those records that I can put on, and every time I feel something, every time I experience something that's a little different, and every time, like, that I think, you know, maybe I'm gonna get sick of this, there's something else that really pops out. And I just love them as a band, as a collective, their chemistry musically and as people, but also how, and Tara sort of mentioned this with her Radiohead comment about, they're artists that really stay true to themselves, and that's what I always admired about Shannon. That, like, no matter what he's doing, I mean, you watch that Woodstock performance, and he's just, like, wearing his girlfriend's dress, and Lord knows whatever he's doing, but it's, like, he's so present. It's amazing.
Yeah.
You know?
It is, yeah. And, you know, I made that film with Taryn and Colleen called All I Can Say.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's... was cathartic for me since I knew Shannon and the band, and for everybody else too. So.
Now, I want to ask you a question. Can you tell us the story behind Soup? Behind the... Just behind your concept for the album cover and your experience with that record?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's... all right. So I'm getting asked questions now. Okay. Well, I did go to Kingsway in New Orleans to photograph the band while they were recording. And... you know, I think being in New Orleans, you know, Gumbo wouldn't have
for
been
sure.
a great name for them because they're not from there, but
right.
the idea of a lot of things going to a soup.
Right.
And when they told me of the story about the record and the title, we all came up with an idea of doing a photograph of someone eating a bowl of soup and creating that sort of the name of the band in the soup. And the guy on the cover is Andy Wallace, who actually recorded the record.
Oh,
and,
cool.
Is a legend in his own.
Sure.
On his own. And so, so we actually took those photographs in a tiny little diner on 37th Street and 10th Avenue before I moved my studio there, like years before.
That's so cool.
Yeah. So.
Oh, so in the city?
In the city,
okay.
Yeah, in Manhattan. So. Okay, well, what? Tell us what song you're going to play.
So I'm going to play off of Soup, which is one of my favorite records of all time. I'm going to play Mouthful of Cavities. It's interesting because you asked me to learn the harmony parts for this when we did the All I Can Say after show.
Yes.
And so I've sort of come up with a hybrid. Also, one of the things about that song that I always loved was Jenna Krause's harmonies are so haunting. And it's like one of those very, very like stereotypical Melon things is they have these very interesting harmonies and doubling of harmonies in and out of time. So this is a song that when I hear this, I feel a lot. I think about Shannon, it feels like the band. It's a good like summary of them as a band, and it's a great song. So I'm gonna do my version of Mouthful of Cavities. Okay. Thank you. everything.